Hey, what's up, everyone? It's Derek with Nerd or Die, and I'm really excited to bring you our newest free resource, an Overwatch-themed Twitch panel maker. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create and save your own customized panels, all of which only requires a web browser. Let's get right into it. Before we get started, I want to say a huge thanks to all of my patrons and members of Discord that helped me beta test this maker. We designed this with the animated Overwatch overlay and custom notifications in mind, so if you're using those, it should fit nicely in with your stream design. Now, to get started, let's head over to nerdordie.com. The direct link will be in the description below. If we scroll down just a bit, we'll see the panel maker. If you've used our previous panel maker, this should feel very similar. However, it does have some major improvements. If your panel maker doesn't look exactly like mine in this example, then you may need to just refresh the page or change the setting in the panel maker to get everything loaded properly. The first thing we can do is customize the icon color. Simply click inside the color selector, and then you can try out some of the palette colors on the left, or on the right you can use the color slider boxes and get a more unique color. You can also use the input box below to enter in the exact color hex code if you like. Next is the text color. This works just like the icon color, and I typically recommend choosing a color that has some contrast with the background that you're selecting. This will make it a lot easier to read. Let's then move on to the background color. This is a simple dropdown that allows you to select different background panel designs. Currently, we only have a few color options, but we plan on adding more in the future. So let us know what colors you'd like to see in the comments below. The badge color allows you to choose a color for the surrounding area of the icon. Again, there's only a few options right now, so make sure to check back for any updates if there's a color you'd like to be added that isn't there just yet. The panel text input box allows you to set what the text says. When designing panels, I usually recommend starting with the longest word in order to keep the text sizes uniform. That, of course, isn't required at all, but it's a tip I like to recommend. So let's pretend we want to make a panel that links to our Twitter account. I'll enter Twitter into the text box. I want to quickly note that some of the fonts only use capital letters, regardless of what you input in this box, but we'll talk about customizing your font in just a bit. Next is the icon dropdown. I can simply select Twitter here and it will swap in the Twitter icon. You'll probably notice a list of icons, but please let me know if you think we left out any that are important to streamers. I made sure to include a blank icon for all of you that can use Photoshop, GIMP, or similar, and then want to take this design to the next level. We also included a Nerd or Die icon in the list in case you'd like to credit our site or YouTube channel in any way. We always appreciate that. So anyways, with the Twitter icon selected, it's time to choose a font. You'll see that the font Oswald is entered here, and the cool thing about this section is that you can enter the font name of any font that you have installed of your PC, and it will use that. For example, Overwatch uses the font BigNoodleTitling. Let's say we want to use that in our design. First, we need to make sure that we download and install the font onto our system. The download link is in the description below, and you can find it on defont.com, which is a great resource for finding your perfect font. Now, once it's installed, you might need to refresh or reopen your browser. Anyways, let's type BigNoodleTitling into the text box. We'll see that using spaces causes the font to not work properly. So I'm going to remove the spaces and everything should load fine. In the description, I'll have exactly how I type this font name available for you to copy and paste in case you're having any trouble with this part. As I mentioned, you should be able to use almost any font you have installed and type it into this box. Typically, I've found the most success with entering the font without spaces. Sometimes the names are slightly different as well, so to make this easier, we might change how this works in the future. The next dropdown allows you to select the style for your font. Remember that not all fonts have italic or bold styles. So for this instance, I'm going to leave it on italic. Let's move on to the range sliders. These are very straightforward. The first one, text size, increases or decreases the text size on the panel. Text horizontal align changes the horizontal positioning or the left and right positioning of the text. By default, it's set to 130 pixels, but with italic text, I sometimes bump it down just a bit. Text vertical aligned is the same thing, but for the vertical or up and down positioning of the text. Once everything is looking fine and dandy, you can save the file by entering a file name in the last text box and then hitting download. So I'll type in Twitter here and then just hit download, and we'll have our twitter.png saved on our computer, and this will be ready to upload directly to Twitch. If for some reason the download button is not working, you can also right-click the panel and click Save Image As, but of course the button with the file name is recommended. Well, at the time of this video, this about wraps up all the options that we have for our new panel maker. As I mentioned, I really want to add more to this in the future and improve it even further, but I honestly just couldn't wait any longer to get it out to all of you. We have some really awesome new resources coming out in the future, so make sure to follow us on Twitter to hear about those updates very soon. Again, a huge thank you to my patrons and members of the Beta Test Discord server. Also, we just changed up our Patreon rewards a little bit, so if you'd like to support more content like this, make sure to check that out. Please don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more great streaming and video game related content. And if you have any questions at all about this video or how to use the panel maker, leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching.